everyone, Ian here, and behind me is a new listing of mine in Marina del Rey, California. This is Altair, the 2007 Jeanneau 42 deck salon. So let me show you some of the features and benefits that this particular vessel has to offer.
All right, so here we are looking at Altair, the 2007 Jeanneau 42 deck salon that is designed by Mark Lombard, famous naval architect who's done a really amazing job creating a stable, fast, comfortable hull design. And then with the collaboration of Jeanneau, coming up with this deck salon that really is quite impressive in its styling and design, really giving it a timeless look with this kind of cat eye window here, large top windows and opening hatches that just flood the salon with natural light. All right, so as we come aboard the vessel, I also want to point out that we have a continuous tow rail here. We have opening ports right here for the dock lines to properly put all the right load on the cleat. The right load on the cleat is actually in the vertical position, not the horizontal position. So this is a really nice testament to all these small details that are found on the Jeanneau product. As we come aboard the vessel, I'm going to take you up to the bow first. As we go up to the bow, we have this Dodger with built-in stainless steel grab handle, large Harkin Traveler with a Selden double spreader mast. On the mast itself, we have a Windpoint wind speed TV antenna. We have the radar with stainless steel Riley mount, and then in mast frilling with quantum sails. Coming up to the bow, again, these large windows here are very, very nice. We have opening hatches, and then coming up to the anchor locker, we have leading into the anchor locker, double bow rollers here, a little bow seat up forward, and this is a quick windlass and a large anchor locker. We have a control here for the up and down switch as well. All right. Looking back at the deck profile of the 42DS, you can see again, just timeless classic designs, very, very efficient with all the sheets and halyards leading into the cockpit. Underneath the Dodger connector and bimini is this large cockpit. As we come into the cockpit itself, you can see just the multiple sections of cockpit space. So we have the upper seating section here that's kind of protected by the Dodger, a large cockpit seating around this beautiful high gloss teak cockpit table, and then we have the seating here behind the helms. Getting off the vessel is quite easy. There are three steps down, hot and cold swim step shower. We have propane lockers underneath this nav seat here. At the helm itself, we have our throttle controls, our engine instrumentation, and then we have our wind, our multi-repeaters, which is depth and speed, and then our below deck linear autopilot with built-in rudder reference. Two-speed Harkin electric winches control the head sail, and then we have a two-speed Harkin electric winch off to the port side, which controls the furling in and out. Centrally located is this C80 Raymarine chart plotter. What we have here in this really nice sealed pod is our charts, radar. Then you have multiple pages here that you can go to so you could, you know, have full charts with radar overlay. It's all in color, very nice, very easy touch button. Just above that is a 12 volt outlet and a light switch for the cockpit table. Underneath this bench seat is a large storage area. We have the second helm, which is a multi-repeater 1-point wind speed, and then controls to our two-speed Harkin winch. Compass at both. Another thing I really want to point out to you is the design of the cockpit. It's really nice. They've integrated these kind of wheel wells under here, so you have good stability and footing as well too. And it is pretty impressive. Now, one thing that really sets the 42DS apart, believe it or not, is the telltale is right here. So what they've done in the aft cabin is they've actually raised this up and they've added a window here. So you can open this up, get ventilation. But when we go down into the aft cabin, you're gonna see what this little, you know, kind of footrest table base actually does, which is impressive. We have large lazarette lockers off to both starboard and port side cockpit speakers. And then, as I mentioned, this is kind of like a three-part cockpit, which is quite nice, but you can actually sit up here and be protected by the dodger. Manual winch off to the starboard side, electric two-speed off to port. The companionway door slides into place, and this top lid closes this off and locks it. All right, let's go down below. As we come down below, there are a series of steps. There are five steps. We have the galley off to the starboard side. The galley is set up with, a lot of nice features here, but I want to give you this kind of span into the salon. It really is remarkable what the deck salon provides you. And again, if you're looking for a nice open feel, this is something to seriously consider. Back to the galley, two burner stove and oven, microwave above that, storage compartments, and a very large deep refrigerator. Refrigerator itself has two sections down below, freezer compartment located there. Just above that, storage. We have our electric propane valve, GFI 110 breaker, and then this large double stainless steel sink under this cover. Also note the backsplash here and good countertop space. Lots of storage down below, and then an opening trash can right underneath this sink. All right, because we are a deck salon and we have a raised cockpit, you'll have an extra step here, but it does really give you a nice walkway down. It's beautifully trimmed with hardwoods. Directly across from the galley is our nav station and access to the head and shower compartment for the aft cabin. But let's focus on the nav station. Here at the nav station, we do have an opening seat here. Notice that it is also curved. So when you are sailing, it is also comfortable to be here. A nice large platform here at the nav station. We do have an Xantrax 1800 watt inverter. We have our 110 systems here with the water heater, plugs, and battery charger. Our 12-volt systems here, which is our lighting, our navigation, refrigerator, and so forth. We have a multi-repeater that indicates the fuel water levels. There are two tanks on this, and then also domestic, meaning the house, and engine start battery controls. VHF control here, GFI outlet, and Sony stereo player there. All right, spanning through the salon, this is the luxury salon table. We have a nice large U-shaped seating. This is ultra leather, very, very durable. Same stuff that my father-in-law has on his Jeanneau. And trust me, my kids have yet to destroy it. We have the table leaves that fold up on both sides. These are the supports that slide into place. And so when you do that, you can see just how nice it is to gain access into this area when not using it as a dining table. On this particular year, what I love about it is they actually have this all trimmed out in wood. There are curtains that close off these windows, handhelds here, overhead lighting, and then side ports with curtains as well too. Salon speakers are built into the corners, and yeah, what a beautiful salon. Off to the port side is this large bench seat. Everywhere underneath all the seating is storage. Being that it's a deck salon, we have really deep bilges as well too. And then again, lots of storage in all of these cabinets. All right, coming up to the forward V-berth cabin or VIP cabin, we have a separate head and shower compartment. And then we have behind the door a hanging locker closet and a nice large traditional V-berth up here. The V-berth is set up with kind of a shelving all the way around it. Overhead opening hatch with a vent here that'll kind of let the boat breathe. And then as we open up this, you have your manual Japsco head and sink vanity. This is an angled vanity, which I really like. And then our holding tank access there. Down below on the floor underneath this grate is the shower sump. That's actuated by this little black switch here. So when you're taking a shower, the sink faucet will come up here and lock into place. And you do have an overhead opening hatch with shades and screens. All right. Coming back aft, I want to kind of point out, you do have a door sill here, a little step. Any reason you have this is because the deck salon kind of curves in this way. So it's dropping you down so you enter this door, you know, nice and square. But this will give you a nice profile looking aft of the salon. And again, there are no lights on, and this is all natural light that we have here in the morning, which is really well done. All right, behind the steps with these two little pins is access to the engine compartment. We have access into the dayhead and or master head compartment. This does have a separate shower. There is a stainless steel rod around here, so you can put a shower curtain if you decide to use this. And then again, you have your sink, your vanity, access to the holding tank, your Japsco head. Through this door is access into one of two access into the master cabin. And this is one of very few yachts that actually have a king size bed, which is very impressive. You have a built-in seat here. You have overhead opening hatch there, a side port hatch there, storage underneath this little drawer cabinet here. But check this out, it is really impressive. Now I'm gonna go ahead and sit down here. And this is what I was talking to you about earlier in the cockpit. So there is phenomenal headroom. Most of your new modern deck salons are literally brought down here, but they've raised this up. They've actually raised up this inner part here, adding a window, which really gives you lots of headroom and great ventilation throughout. Behind here, you have access to the backside of the engine, and then underneath this floorboard is your shaft. But again, really nice here. You can see they have artwork on this. You can also put a television if so desired. Bench seats off to starboard and port side, and a large hanging locker and shelving locker, and then a storage unit below here for shoes and what have you. Behind this cabinet, we have 110 12 volt outlets. There is another overhead opening hatch here, and again, your lighting throughout. The companionway door hatch actually slides here, so you can see how that's designed to stow that there, so it really keeps it in a nice position. But here's another preview of this aft cabin. Now walking through into the galley and back into the salon. Well, I hope you found this video to be helpful and informative. If you do like it, please give it a thumbs up. And if you would like more information in regards to the 2007 Jeanneau 42 deck salon, located in Marina del Rey, California, please feel free to contact me at any time, day or night. I look forward to hearing from you and hopefully earning your business. Thank you again.